Installation of the bicycle pump is pretty straightforward. Take the bayonet, and you want to put it down in the hole. You can hear the water sloshing around in there. And we'll bring it on down. Now the next step would be to screw this together. You just bring that out. Now, it's pretty hard to do one-handed, but the next clip will show this connected. And the other thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take this handmade U-bolt and there's some holes in the wood here. You want to get this rigid. It has to be solid. So, you know, there's a lot of motion and action. And I actually broke this once trying to remove this screw. So I'd put some thought into this better than this. I'm going to actually go out and try and buy a real U-bolt that will work. But that's the next step. Okay, so I've got my U-bolt attached with some washers and nut in the back. Again, a U-bolt would probably go a long way. It's probably better to have a long plate. You can see some of those washers are getting stuck in. You want to be cautious not to tighten it down too much because you will break that PVC. And down here, we've just made up our connection there with tightening that up. And make sure this is pretty tight. This system here builds up a lot of pressure because it goes up to the barrel. But, for a regular system, I would advise that you have a system where it comes up a little bit like this, and then you can come back down. I find the pump works better when it's got a little bit of standing water behind the valve, because it's just a cheap PVC valve. So the next step, we're going to take our piston, and we'll get our cap to go all the way. My cap's captured in there by the coupling nut, so it doesn't come off. This is all one unit. And stick that in there. If you listen carefully, you might hear the water that's already in there. And for this system here, I want to get these holes lined up because that's how I reprime the pump. So it's about right down there. And you can see I've got a little screw hole here. So I'll attach the screw. And the next step will be to attach this piece here. And all that is lining it up and screwing this onto here. So I'll do that and we'll get back to you. Okay, and as you can see, I've attached the screw. It keeps the cap on. Like I said, it's 100%. It's kind of sitting there and it's been cracked. It's got to be replaced. And I've also attached this. Now it's important to notice that the coupling direction needs to be in this orientation for the pump to do its thing, for it to go up and down. It's got to go. So sometimes what I'll do is I'll take a wrench and hold it here, and then I'll put the other wrench here and tighten it just to hold this orientation in place. Once it's all the way up against the nut, I'll just put the two wrenches here and tighten it up just to capture it and make sure it's not going to go anywhere. Next step is to put the hose on. This is, I don't know what size it is, 5/8 hose. And I just kind of manhandle it in there. And the hole, with this cut the way it is, it kind of captures it. And if you look closely here, you can kind of see where it's flared out. So it captures it from pulling it out, which is kind of nice. Cram it back in there. And that's it. The pump's put together. Now, next year, what I'll probably end up doing is disconnecting these two systems here. Undo this nut here, undo the nut in the back, and take out the central rod, which would be, I include the 3/4-inch shaft and the eye bolt, just to prevent it from rusting and fit to last a little longer. So now that the pump's put together, next thing we need to do is prime the pump. There's water backed up in the hose because the barrel's full. And even if the barrel was empty, there's enough latent water in the hose that it should be able to prime the pump once or twice. And then you'd have to fill up the barrel to refill the hose. So anyway, we'll open it up. You can see the water is coming out and it's priming the pump. Give it a couple seconds of water in there and then we're good. I'm gonna shut the valve off. Now, all we gotta do is pump. As we pump the water up, it comes out. Now the way I've got this set up, it's got weed cloth that goes around the primer. We just had to have some of that laying around. And there's some rocks there, so any water that overflows the barrel or when I'm doing something like this, the water doesn't go to waste. It gets fed back into the sump pit underneath this rock, underneath this rock, and back into the pit.